introduce Owen Jones. Owen Jones is not just a writer and a great comrade and a supporter of the austerity movement. He's trying to lead something very different from where we are right now. He's a great friend of ours and he's going to address you right now. Owen.
London, you are looking pretty beautiful today. It is cold out, but there's lots of warmth in this square. Firstly, I just want you to do something, because they've been working so hard all day. So can you give a big round of applause to the signers? She didn't see that coming. She's got to sign that own hair. Congratulations. That's how it works. Friends, if we don't protest at a time like this, then when? We've seen with the Panama Papers that it is one rule for the rich and it is one rule for everybody else. Now friends, we have made a case, people in this square, for years, and it has been this, that the cops are ideologically motivated. That the cops hurt the poorest sections of society. That the cops make a mockery of the idea that we're all in this together. Which well-known rabid lefty decided to echo those arguments? Iain Duncan Smith. I have to say, when he resigned, it was a bit like Margaret Thatcher resigning over the treatment of the miners. And the reality is, friends, we have made these arguments for years and we've been attacked and belittled and demonised. But we were right all along and they were absolutely wrong and we stand here vindicated. Now, we have a long responsibility, a huge responsibility in this square. All over Europe and all over the United States, there is seething anger and resentment and frustration at societies rigged and run as playgrounds for a rich elite, as the living standards of millions stagnate or fall. But the anger is going in two different directions. It's going in the direction of a politics of hope, of building societies run in the interests of majority and confronting the powerful. And on the other hand, a politics of fear, of blaming immigrants and Muslims and poor people and the unemployed, anybody but the powerful responsible for the mess we're in. In the United States, you have that most unlikely icon of the politics of hope, a septuagenarian Jewish self-described socialist from the name Bernie Sanders. And on the other, this is going to be like panto, I've just realised, on the other hand, that increasingly quasi-fascist clown, Donald Trump. Very good. But you've seen it here in Britain, the Corbyn phenomenon. On the other hand, that bunch of charlatans who blame immigrants while backing policies to privatise the NHS and cut taxes on the rich, UKIP. In Spain, and I've seen them in the crowd, Podemos, a party founded just 2 years ago, you've got millions of votes. On the other hand, the National Front in France. And this is what we learn. This is a historic moment of anger and fear. And we haven't recovered from the last crisis and another one may be on its way. And if we don't get this right now, if we don't get our act together, then it will be the politics of fear that fills that vacuum. But it can be a different way. If we stand up with a message that can inspire the majority, at a time when the living standards of millions has fallen for the longest period since the 19th century, when young people face a worse lot of life than their parents, when low-paid workers get up in the morning and earn their poverty day after day, when women disproportionately are hammered by these cops, when our junior doctors, who we rely on, every single one of us, are punished and hammered by this government of millionaires. But we can argue for something else. Not a system where the rich tax dodgers design the tax laws and allow the big corporations to pay nothing whilst people at the bottom have the old bell knocking on the door of their cashing hand. We can build a different society, one based on the real wealth creators, working people, the people who keep our country ticking day after day after day. When we build the housing, when we build the housing, good, decent, quality housing, when we create the skilled jobs of the future, where we ensure everyone has a real living wage, not the fraudulent living wage of this government. When we have good, decent education and a healthcare system funded properly. These are goals and aims which should not be lofty ambitions. These are the basic rights that the people of a rich country like this should take as read and as for granted. And just to wrap up, this square we stand in, this square, it has so much history. It has so much history of the ancestors before us who fought for our rights and for our freedoms. They were not given to us by the generosity and the charity of the powerful. They were fought for at such cost and such sacrifice by people who huddled in this very square for generations. This square was filled once by trade unionists in the 19th century who fought for the dignity of working people and their rights. This square was filled by the Chartists who fought for democracy in the 19th century. This square was filled by suffragettes who had lauded in secular sense, but in their time were dragged out by police officers and locked up in prisons with chains forced down their necks. This square was filled by people who fought racism and sexism and homophobia. You were battened and spat at the people who fought for the NHS and for our welfare state. This square, we should remember, was once filled by those who were mocked and ridiculed and demonised and persecuted, but all of them vindicated by history. We stand on the shoulders of giants, and we owe it to them, we owe it to our ancestors to keep that fight alive, a baton passed from generation to generation. Have the same determination, the same resilience, the same courage, the same determination our ancestors showed, and we will not just take on this government, but we will not just get a government elected to represent the interests of the majority, but friends, we will build a society, not run as a playground for the elite, but run in the interests of the majority. That is the aim, that is our dream, that's what we're fighting for. I hope you're fighting solidarity.